okay class, that's all for today. And for your assignment, answer this transaction for you to be able to answer it correctly. I give you some clues regarding it. This is about prepaid insurance and insurance expense. So the transaction is that's all, everyone. Have a nice day. Class dismissed.
Ano to? Prepaid insurance and insurance expense? The only thing I know are life insurance of St. Peter. Heis. Ewan. Oh, I should watch information on the internet or YouTube about prepaid insurance and insurance expense. Okay, let's start the learning.
My name is Fuki, your number one key in your accountancy. Brut, brut. Oh, I know why you're here, watching Fuki's video. You're struggling in fundamentals of accountancy, business and management, huh? So, you click this video to learn, and this video is the perfect for you to learn what's the difference between prepaid insurance and insurance expense. So first, what is prepaid insurance? Anyone? How about insurance expense? They are both connected to each other. So guys, any idea? It looks like you're having a hard time on this one. Let's call Prepaid to teach us what is prepaid insurance and insurance expense. Let's call Cree and Pie. Shout, Prepaid. Again, guys, Prepaid.
Hello, everybody.
Hola, soy Dora.
My name is Cree.
My name is Pai.
We are Kripai. Prepaid insurance is cost of insurance paid in advance, typically on a monthly or yearly basis. It is paid but not yet incurred. Sa Tagalog, ito ay isang uri ng bayarin na binabayaran mo in advance bago mo pagamitin ang isang produkto or serbisyo. This type of insurance is commonly used in many aspects of our lives. Example 1. A person might purchase prepaid health insurance to cover the cost of medical treatments and visits to the doctor. Example 2. A car owner might purchase prepaid car insurance to cover the cost of repairs or accidents.
Now, let's define what is insurance expense. Under the accrual basis of accounting, insurance expense is the cost of insurance that has been incurred, has expired, or has been used up during the current accounting period. These are a few examples of how insurance expenses are incurred in our daily lives. Example number 1. A person might incur insurance expenses for health insurance, car insurance, or homeowner's insurance. Example number 2, a business might incur insurance expenses for property insurance, liability insurance, or workers' compensation insurance.
Okay, let's sum up the information. Prepaid insurance is a portion paid in advance but not yet consumed. Once consumed, whether partial or full, that portion used or sometimes referred to as expired will be converted to an expense, specifically using the account title Insurance Expense.
First, prepaid insurance. It is shown on the asset side of the balance sheet, current asset to be exact, that has a debit balance because it's not consumed. The debit balance indicates the amount that remains prepaid as of the date of the balance sheet. Remember na sa balance sheet, ang kasama lang doon ay current and non-current assets, current and non-current liabilities, and shareholders' equity.
On the other hand, insurance expense is debited in a company's accounting records because it represents a current expense. When a company incurs an insurance expense, it is consuming a valuable resource that will provide benefits for a specific period of time. Since the insurance coverage is being consumed, it should be recorded as an expense on the company's income statement.
Tandaan na ang prepaid insurance is first recorded in the asset account on the balance sheet as a current asset.
Once expenses are incurred, the asset account is reduced and an entry is made to the expense account on the income statement.
Wow! So yun pala yung meaning ng prepaid insurance and insurance expense. Thank you, Kripay, for your service.
Kripay, bounce!
Maybe bouncing is Kripay's signature move. Anyways, let's move on to the transaction of prepaid insurance and insurance expense. Aha! I know someone who can help us. We should call Jopai.
Alumni girl Jopai, let's answer this transaction. In the year 2022, December 5, Mr. Kamote paid 12,000 pesos for a half-year life insurance starting in the month of January 2023. So the debit is prepaid insurance worth 12,000 and credit cash worth 12,000 pesos. For the next month, which year 2023, January 5, the debit is insurance expense worth 2,000 pesos and credit is prepaid insurance worth 2,000 pesos. So nakuha ang 2,000 pesos kapag dinivide ang 12,000 in 6 months. Nang muli kang makasama,
ano ang tinagay, hindi mapalagay. Ako'y nasasaktan, pag-awag mo kanyang kamay. Sa kanya ka sa tanghali, aking ka sa gabi. Pagpila sa umaga, yung wala ka na sa tabi. Meron pa kati, gusto kita na mapasabi.
Let's go to the another transaction.
Kaya kita na kaway na lagi mong iisipin. Kung hindi ka para sa akin, huwag mo lang pasalimutin na ikay mahal.
On July 6, 2022, Singkamas Company paid Goto Hill Incorporated 24,000 pesos on account in property insurance for an 8-month period beginning in August 2022. So just like in the first transaction, the debit is prepaid insurance worth 24,000 pesos and the credit is accounts payable worth 24,000 pesos. So just like in the first transaction, again, so just like in the first transaction, the debit is prepaid insurance worth 24,000 pesos and the credit is accounts payable worth 24,000 pesos. So next month, on August 6, 2022, Singkamas Company paid again for the insurance they bought. They need to pay 24,000 pesos for 8 months. So you need to divide 24,000 by 8 months which is 3,000 pesos per month. So the debit is insurance expenses worth 3,000 pesos and the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. So again, paano ba nakuha ang 3,000 pesos? They need to pay 24,000 pesos for 8 months. So you need to divide it by 8 months. 24,000 divided by 8 months is equal to 3,000 pesos per month. So the debit is insurance expense worth 3,000 pesos and the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. September 6, 2022, Singtamas company paid 3,000 pesos again. Just like in the month of August, the debit is insurance expense worth 3,000 pesos and the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. On October 6, 2022, you know the drill, guys. Singtamas company paid 3,000 pesos again. So just like the August and September, in October, you need to pay it again. So the debit is insurance expense worth 3,000 pesos and the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. November 6, 2022, same again on August, September, and October. Kahit undas na, Singtamas company need to pay 3,000 pesos again para sa insurance na binili nila. Again, the debit is insurance expense worth 3,000 pesos and the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. Pasko na, giliw, magsalo na tayo. Meron na tayong pinapayat kasi metanot sugar na sa gabi nito. Ah, na-prank ko kayo, singer. Chris, di ba pala Pasko? December 6, 2022, Singtamas company paid again 3,000 pesos. So just like the August, September, October, November, and now December. So the debit is insurance expense worth 3,000 pesos and the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. So mag-next year na, matatapos mo ba ang pagbabayad ng Singtamas company? Of course, guys, you need to remember kung ilang beses ka nagbayad sa, for example, Singtamas company. From the month of August until December, nagbayad siya ng 3,000, total of 15,000 pesos. Kunting kaya ba talaga matatapos na yung pagbabayad niya? So, starting January 6, 2023, same lang sa previous month ang pagbabayad niya. So, magbabayad pa siya ng 3,000 pesos. So, the debit is insurance expense worth 3,000 pesos. And the credit is prepaid insurance worth 3,000 pesos. Hanggang March 6, 2023, ganoon lang din ang process hanggang matapos sa 8 months payment based sa contract o sa usapan ng pagbabayad bago niya mabuo ang 24,000 pesos. Okay guys, thank you.
Now I know, what's the difference between insurance expense and prepaid insurance? Guys, kung kayo nahihirapan kung ano ang prepaid insurance and insurance expense, then you watch our video with Fuki, Kripay, and Jopay. So I hope you guys learn from this video. Bye guys!
Transaction empty. We can wander through the debit and the so and credit. Have a long with me to subject accountancy, where we can learn about business. everlasting dream. Alumni transaction, I'll show them all with you. Maybe by next summer, we won't all change our tune. Just the one to be an accountant and bookies, record up new numbers and living so merrily. Alumni transaction, I'll show them all with you. I'll be here for you always. Make sure look up passionately. Come along with me and the columnar entities. We can wander through the debit and do so in credit, living so merrily.
Yeah.